Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Here in the UK, over the last week, we've had some high pressure, as you can see from this barograph trace. So once the full moon's got out of the way, I've taken the opportunity to try and do some imaging. Now, there's an object in the night sky at the moment called Comet ATLAS. Now, this was supposed to be the next big thing, the next bright comet, potentially a naked eye comet later in the year. But from all accounts, the object is fading now, and it's possible that the nucleus has disintegrated. So I'm going to try and take the opportunity to capture a comet and see what I can record with my William Optics GT81. Now, looking onto the Larium before setting up, I noticed that there's another comet in the same part of the night sky, which is Comet PANSTARRS. So in fact, this video is me trying to capture two comets in one night. Okay, so that's it. Two comets in one night. A bit of processing to do tomorrow. We'll see how the images compare. Okay, so I've taken 31 minute frames and I've put them through Deep Sky Stacker. And I've chosen to use the comet mode, which I always find a little bit fiddly, but after getting used to it again, you can get a good result. So this is the image of Comet ATLAS. It shows a nice tail. The central nucleus of the comet, though, is quite diffuse, and I guess that's indicative of the nucleus breaking up. Compare that with PANSTARRS, is lower in the sky for me, a bit murkier, looking in that direction at that height. A brighter nucleus, although the actual object is fainter than ATLAS, but a more concentrated emission of light. Probably a little bit easier therefore to capture, but no tail. And then comparing the two, pretty happy to be able to capture two comets. I think they were 6 degrees apart in the night sky, very different. The top one is no longer going to be the next big thing. So I hope it's been useful. Thanks for watching. If you like videos like this one, then please subscribe to Jenham's Astro. And talk to you soon.